Good morning, class. I am your assistant teacher of class 6th. Today we will do chapter number 2 of geography, which is on page number 11. Open page number 11. Second chapter is Realms of the Earth. Today we will do the reading of the chapter. So let's start the reading. The Earth is a unique planet because it is the only planet in the solar system which supports life. Land, water and air are the three realms of the Earth into which the Earth can be divided. Since all these three realms support life, life itself forms the fourth domain. The Earth has a distinction of being at a reasonable distance from the sun. With the emergence of life, the Earth's climate acquired and settled down to exhibit definite uniformity. Climate conditions caused rock disintegration. It resulted in the formation of soil, which forms a vital part of Earth's crust. Thus, the four realms are interactive and cannot be separated from each other. These domains or realms are lithosphere, land, hydrosphere, water, atmosphere, air, and biosphere, life. Now, lithosphere. What is lithosphere? The outermost solid layer of the Earth is known as the lithosphere. It is also called the crust of the Earth. This realm consists of landmass of the continents and the floor of the oceans. We find mountains, plateaus and plains here. We also find life, plants, animals and humans here. It has a soil layer that allows plant growth. Resources like oil, gas and minerals are also found here. The lithosphere is made up of two types of crust, continental and oceanic. The continental crust runs below the continents. It is the upper crust and is also called soil, as it is made up of silica and alumina. Its thickness varies under 40 and 100 km. It is thicker under the mountains. The oceanic crust is the lower crust and is found below the oceans as well as under the soil. It is also called sima as it is made up of silica and magnesium. It is much thinner with an average thickness of just 6 km. Continents. Continents make up the landmass of... Come to the next page, page number 12. Landmass of lithosphere. There are 7 continents in all. Most of the continents lie in the northern hemisphere. Asia is the largest continent in the world. It covers 1/3 of the Earth's total land surface and is surrounded by the Arctic Ocean in the north, the Indian Ocean in the south, and the Pacific Ocean in the east. It has the highest mountains and the lowest points in the world. Some of the world's longest rivers, such as Yangtze, Euphrates, Indus and Ganga, as well as deserts such as Gobi and Thar, are in Asia. It also has the highest population of all continents. Ancient civilizations like the Indus Valley and the Mesopotamian civilizations thrived here. Africa is the second largest continent in the world, covering about 1/5 of the Earth's land surface. The continent is surrounded by the Atlantic Ocean in the west and the Indian Ocean in the east. Africa is joined to Asia by the Isthmus of Suez. Most of Africa is a vast plateau with the Atlas Mountains in the northwest and the Cape Ranges in the south. It has the world's largest hot deserts. The Sahara Desert, Kalahari and Namib are the other deserts in Africa. A remarkable landform in this continent is the East African Rift Valley. Africa has the longest river in the world. द नाइल द एंशियंट सेटलमेंट्स ऑफ इजिप्ट वर लोकेटेड अलोंग इट्स बैंक्स. अदर मेजर रिवर्स इन द कॉन्टिनेंट आर नीगर, कॉन्गो एंड जैम्बेजी. Africa is famous for its large variety of wildlife. Europe. Europe is the second smallest country, covering about 1/15 of the Earth's land surface. It forms a continuous landmass with Asia, and so together they are called Eurasia. It is bounded by the Arctic Ocean in the north and Atlantic Ocean in the west, and the Mediterranean Sea and the Black Sea in the south. It has a very irregular coastline which extends to 38,000 km and is marked by bays and fjords. Europe is also marked by thousands of lakes in Finland, Norway and Sweden, the Rhine, Rhone, Danube, Volga, Dnieper and Thames are some of the major rivers here. North America. North America is the third largest continent in the world. It is surrounded by the Arctic Ocean in the north and the Atlantic Ocean in the east and the Pacific Ocean in the south and west. This continent lies in the western hemisphere. North and South America are joined by the Isthmus of Panama. North America has the second largest coastline of 60,000 kilometers. Some of the major rivers here are the Mississippi, Mackenzie, Red, Yukon and Lawrence. The Great Lakes in the North America is the largest group of freshwater lakes on the earth. North America also has the most striking canyon in the world, the Great Grand Canyon. More than half of the population of this continent lives in the USA. Less than 10% lives in Canada. Though it covers 2/5 of the continent's lands. South America is the fourth largest continent in the world, covering 1/8 of the Earth's land surface. It is bounded by the Pacific Ocean on the west and the Atlantic Ocean on the north and east. The Isthmus of Panama joins this continent to North America. South America has the largest river basin of the world, drained by the river Amazon, Paraguay, Uruguay and Orinoco are the other major rivers. Australia. Australia is only continent smallest that is also a country, the sixth largest. It is surrounded on all sides by oceans and seas and is also known as island continent. Australia is marked by low relief and aridity. The major rivers of the continent are Murray Darling, Flinders and Swan. The Great Barrier Reef is one of the remarkable relief features of the Australia. It is made of corals. Look for it on the northeastern coast of the continent. Do you know why Australia was called the last frontier? Antarctica is the fifth largest country. Mostly it is covered by a huge sheet of ice. Antarctica lies in a circular pattern around the South Pole with an average elevation of 2,195 meters. It is the world's highest continent. Nearly 95% of the continent is covered by ice and snow. So no one really knows what lies underneath the thick ice sheet. Due to this reason, the only form of life here are the cold adapted land plants and animals. This is the part A of the video. In the next part, we will do the next topic, which is hydrosphere. You have to read the whole topic of lithosphere. In the next video, we will do the part B, which is hydrosphere. Thank you, class, and have a nice day. Goodbye.